In this video, I'm going to be demonstrating how to create relationships in MySQL using the Workbench. And for the purposes of this demonstration, I created a simple database with two tables in it, customers and orders. So if you need to know how to do something like that, you can watch my video, How to Create a Database, and I'll leave a link for that in the description. I'll also post the data that I imported into these two tables on GitHub. So if you want to follow along or try it yourself after the video, you're going to be able to do that. All right, so we create a database, right? I switch into the database, and then yes, I just showed the tables that are in there. All right, and if after doing this, you cannot see the database or the tables over here in the schema list, you're just going to go ahead and click this refresh button. All right, and then before I get too far, I'm going to create an ERD for this database. So I'm going to go to database and then reverse engineer. I have a video that explains this a little bit more in depth here, so I'm just going to skip over most of this stuff. It's just a wizard. And like I said, if you're interested in how to do this in more depth, you can watch my video on how to create an EER diagram. And we more or less just need to see what it looks like. Okay, so here's a diagram of that database. All right, and right, there's the customers, there's the orders, and then we can see, okay, there's a customer ID here, probably should be the primary key, right? Uniquely identify customers. And then, okay, it must be related to customer ID in the orders table, right? So one customer able to place many orders, or actually 0, 1 or many orders. All right, so I could manually just sort of click on the one to many relationship button here and draw the relationship in between the tables. If I do that, I'm going to have to forward engineer this diagram into a new database for it to take effect. So I don't really want to do that. All right, I already have a perfectly good database. I'm just going to add this foreign key constraint there. And then, yeah, maybe we can come back and take a look at a new EER diagram after that. All right, so there's a couple of different ways we can do this. And we're in the workbench, so I'm going to use the GUI method first. Right, I'm just going to hover over the orders table here, and I'm going to select alter table. Okay, so right now it doesn't have a primary key. We might as well in the process here give it a primary key. All right, and then I'm just going to click on this tab down here, foreign keys. We're going to give the foreign key a name. All right, and then we're going to tell the workbench that this references the customer's table. And then we're going to check that customer ID, and we're going to say it's related to the customer ID in the customer table. All right, and yep, we get this error message. And basically what this is saying is that first of all, when you're creating a relationship, it has to go from a primary key in one table, right, to a column that basically references that in the second table. Neither one of these tables has a primary key. Right, so I just imported the data. There's no way to add a primary key there. Right, so I'm going to have to at least do that. All right, to make a primary key, you can only use certain types of data. And when you import data and it's string data, it always comes in as this generic text. All right, and you cannot create primary keys on text data. So first thing we're going to have to do is go into the customer table, add a primary key, and then right, change the data type to something that supports being a primary key. All right, once we're done there, we're going to have to come back into this orders table, and we're going to have to relate tables of the same kind of data. So I'm going to have to change the customer ID to make it the same kind of data that's in the customer table, and then we're going to be able to add this foreign key. All right, so I'm just going to click OK here. And I'm going to close this without saving any changes. And I'm going to start in the customers table this time. So right click, alter. Okay, we're going to take the customer ID. We're going to make it primary. And then I'm going to change the data type over here to character and 4. So that should match the data that is in the table, and I'm going to hit apply. All right, so whenever you do this, right, it looks like you're doing it in a graphical user interface, right? But actually, right, the workbench just generates some SQL for you, and you click apply and then finish. All right, so changes are done here, right? And if you want to take a look at that, we can run a describe on customers. All right, so now we can see that the data's changed from text to character and four characters, and there's a primary key there. Okay, let's go back into orders then so we can add our foreign key constraint. Right click, alter. All right, I am going to add a primary key here. It's just good practice. And then I'm going to go to foreign key. Pretty much do the same thing, right? Customer ID. All right, we're going to reference the customers table. And then, right, it's going to be customer ID to customer ID. Okay, so now it's complaining because it needs me to change the data type here. So we'll click on customer ID and we'll change it from text to character. It should let us do everything now. So I'll hit apply. We're going to generate all that SQL and hit finish. All right, so now we have a foreign key, right? If I describe orders, we'll see what that looks like. All right, so there's my primary, and then this is how it refers to a foreign key. And if you want, we can generate a new EER diagram. Okay, and so now we have that relationship in there. All right, and then if you hover over it, you can see the related fields. Okay, so that is the GUI method of adding a foreign key or a relationship to your database. All right, and then, to me, it might be just a little bit easier to do this with SQL rather than clicking all these buttons inside the GUI. All right, so I'm going to show you the second way. And to do this, right, I'm going to start over. So I'm going to drop the database. And I'll just quickly re-import the data and show you how to do this programmatically with SQL. Okay, so we're about back to where we started. Right. And then, if I describe orders, okay, there's no primary key. The data is text. Right. So I basically started over again. All right. So let's see how to sort of set this thing up and then add the foreign key with SQL. All right. So we're basically going to do about the same thing. We're going to alter a table, except for I'm not doing it through this point, click, and drag interface. Right. So I'm going to alter table. And it's going to be the customers table. All right, and since it's SQL, there's always or usually more than one way of doing things. I am going to use modify here. You could use change. All right, and I'm going to modify the customer ID in that table, and I'm going to make it character and four, and then I'm going to make it the primary key. Okay, I'll run that, and we can just kind of verify that the changes have occurred. Although I got the green check mark down here, it must have worked, but let's take a look. All right, so there it is, character, primary. All right, we're going to do something similar to the orders table. So I'll just copy all that, paste, right? And then instead of customers, right, we're going to modify orders, and we're not going to make that primary. We're going to make it just modified, right? Change the data type, and I'll run that. Okay, we might as well add the primary key here, right? So for the orders table, right, modify, and then that's going to be the order ID, and that's integer data, and then we'll just say it's primary key. Okay, if you want, we'll describe that. All right, so there it is, right? Character four. All right, and the order ID is primary. That's nice. All right, so now we're ready to just go ahead and add the foreign key. All right, and that is also an alter table. All right, we're going to alter orders here. And we're going to add a constraint. All right, and it's going to be a foreign key. All right, and we're going to say it's the CID. And then we just say it references customers CID there. Okay, let's run that. All right, we got the green check, so it works. And then, you know, I'll just describe orders one more time. All right, and okay, there is my foreign key constraint. All right, so, you know, to me, this is maybe a little bit simpler, right? And of course, I didn't bother to purposefully inflict a bunch of errors first. All right, but you decide which way you want to do it. Okay, so I hope that helps creating relationships with MySQL in the workbench.